उपनिषद मंत्र 7. Welcome everyone. Let's pay our obeisances to Shri Shri Radha Govinda. For without their mercy, we cannot understand anything. Okay, so this is what we are. We are in the second part of Isopanishad, the vision of the Mahabhagavata. Mantra 4 explained why such people are unable to understand Lord's position. He's beyond material calculation. Can only be understood when he reveals himself. We cannot force Krishna. And 5 continues with the 3 apparent contradictory qualities. And this discussion that the Lord has inconceivable potencies which render him unknowable to those whom he does not favor. 6, which we did last week, we discussed about the 3 different levels of devotees, Kanishtha Adhikari, Madhyam Adhikari, Uttam Adhikari. And we also discussed the vision of the Mahabhagavata. Describes the vision of one who can see Krishna everywhere, the Mahabhagavata. 7th, we'll continue describing the consciousness of the Mahabhagavata, which was introduced in Mantra 6. And next week, Mantra 8 will describe some qualities of the Lord as he is known by the Mahabhagavata as described in Mantra 6 and 7. Okay, so this is the mantra. I will chant and then you can raise your hand. Yasmin sarvani bhutani atme va bhudvijanataha tatra ko moha kah shoka ekatvam anupashyataha. Just catch the meter, how I'm chanting, and just stick to the meter if possible. Yasmin sarvani bhutani atme va bhudvijanataha tatra ko moha kah shoka ekatvam anupashyataha. Okay, please raise your hand if you would like to chant. Okay, Uma Karan Mataji, please go ahead.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmeva bodha vijanata tatra ko moha kakshoka ekatvam anupashyata. Hare Krishna Mataji.
Thank you. Okay, everyone else who's not chanting, please try to memorize. Because after 7-8 times you hear, then you should be able to memorize. Kiran Sareen Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Yashmani sarvani bhutani atma vedu vijatnyata tatra ko moha ka shoka ekavam anupashyata. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Vijay Kanan Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmaiva bodhvichanata tatra ko moha kashoga egatvam anupashyatah.
Very nice. Thank you, Mataji. Shri Priya Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmaiva bodhvichanata tatra ko moha kah shoka ekatvam anupashyata.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Nice.
Thank you, Mataji. Gayatri Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmeva bodhvichanatah tatra ko moha kah shoka ekatvam anupashyata.
Thank you. Usha Kamath Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Yasmin sarvani bhutani atma vaibuddha vijnanataha tatra ko moha ka shoka ekatvam anupasyataha.
Very nice. Hare. Thank you, Mataji. Okay, Sneha Joshi Mataji.
Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmaiva bhudvijanataha tatra ko moha ka shoka ekatvam anupashyataha.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna. Kirti Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Yasmin sarvani bhutani आत्मैव भूत विजनात् तत्र को मोह का सोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः।
थैंक यू माताजी। इन डॉक्टर इंदिरा।
हरे कृष्ण माताजी। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत विजानत तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः।
वेरी नाइस। थैंक यू माताजी। रोजा माताजी।
हरे कृष्ण माताजी। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः।
थैंक यू माताजी। ललिता नारायण माताजी।
यस। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः।
थैंक यू माताजी। माताजी यू चैंटेड भगवद गीता टुडे राइट Chapter 8?
Yes, yes.
How was it?
Yeah, I had practice.
Very nice. Thank you. Sorry, it's very late in night for me at that time. I couldn't come. But I'll hear the recording. Hare Krishna. Talk to Nirupama Devi Mataji.
Krishna Mataji. Yasmin Sarvani Bhutani Atmai Vato Tijana Nataha तत्र को मोह सोका एकात्वम अनुपस्थितः।
थैंक यू माताजी। माताजी प्लीज चेक योर ऑडियो सेटिंग्स, योर वॉइस इज हैज लॉट ऑफ स्टैटिक। शोभा मल्ली माताजी।
हरे कृष्णा माताजी। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत जानतः तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः। हरे कृष्ण माताजी।
थैंक यू माताजी। हरे कृष्णा। वसंत कुमार प्रभु।
हरे कृष्ण माताजी। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः।
वेरी नाइस। थैंक यू प्रभु। सूर्य महालक्ष्मी माताजी।
हरे कृष्ण माताजी। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह शोक एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः। हरे कृष्ण माताजी।
कृष्ण। सुजाता सुभाष माताजी। माताजी अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ प्लीज। सुजाता सुभाष माताजी। I'm going to keep moving, Mataji, whenever you can unmute. Neetu, Mataji.
Yasmin Sarvani Bhutani Atmaiva Budvijanataha Tatra Ko Moha Ka Shokha Ekatvam Manupashyataha.
Very nice. Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Girija, Mataji.
Yasmin Sarvani Bhutani Atmaiva Budvijanataha Tatra Ko Moha Ka Shokha एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः।
थैंक यू माताजी। पूनम माताजी। सुजाता माताजी आई बीन टेलिंग यू टू अनम्यूट, आई बीन सेंडिंग यू रिक्वेस्ट, सो यू कैन अनम्यूट व्हेनेवर यू कैन।
हरे कृष्णा माताजी। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः।
थैंक यू माताजी। Rashmi Prabhu.
Hello Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Yashmin Sarvani Bhutani Atmaiva Bhuta Vijanata Tatra Ko Moha Ka Soka Ekatvam Anupashyate.
Very nice. Thank you Mataji. Vijayanti Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Yashmin Sarvani Bhutani Atma Vaibhut Vijanataha तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः। हरे कृष्ण।
थैंक यू माताजी। हरे कृष्ण। गीता माताजी।
हरे कृष्ण माताजी। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यतः।
वेरी नाइस। थैंक यू माताजी। रजनी माताजी।
हरे कृष्ण माताजी। यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मा एव बुद्ध विजानता तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम अनुपश्यता।
थैंक यू माताजी। सुजाता माताजी।
यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि
थैंक यू माताजी. जिग्ना माताजी.
हरे कृष्ण माताजी. यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव बुध विजानतः तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम् अनुपाश्यतः.
थैंक यू माताजी. द्युति द्युति. हरे कृष्ण. यू कैन अनम्यूट.
हरे कृष्ण माताजी.
हरे कृष्ण.
यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव बुद्ध विजनतो तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम् अनुपश्यत.
थैंक यू माताजी. जया तेजवानी माताजी.
हरे कृष्णा. यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मा विभूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह का शोका एकत्वम् अनुपश्यतः. हरे कृष्ण.
हरे कृष्ण. शिल्पजा माताजी.
हरे कृष्ण. यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मवैभूत विजानता तत्र को मोह का शोक एकत्वम् अनुपश्यता.
थैंक यू माताजी. यशोदा माताजी.
हरे कृष्णा. यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैवाभूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह का शोक एकत्वम् अमुष्यत अनुपश्यतः.
हे नाइस. थैंक यू माताजी. डॉक्टर पारिक.
हरे कृष्ण माताजी.
हरे कृष्ण.
यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव वभूत विजानतः तत्र को मोह कः शोक एकत्वम् अनुपश्यतः.
थैंक यू डॉक्टर पारिक. नमिता माताजी.
हरे कृष्ण माताजी. यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मैव भूत विजानता तत्र को मोह का शोक एकत्वम् अनुपश्यता.
थैंक यू नमिता माताजी. ओके आई एम गोना स्टार्ट. प्रियदर्शनी माताजी, विमला माताजी एंड वंदना माताजी, यू विल बी द फर्स्ट टू रीड, सो प्लीज कीप योर हैंड्स रेज्ड, बट आई एम गोना गेट स्टार्टेड. ट्रांसलेशन बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस श्रील प्रभुपाद. श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय. One who always sees all living entities as spiritual sparks in quality one with the Lord becomes a true knower of things. What then can be illusion or anxiety for him? So again, one who always sees, this is a Mahabhagavata, one who always sees all living entities as spiritual sparks in quality one with the Lord becomes a true knower of things. What then can be illusion or anxiety for him? So very nice verse. So except for Madhyam Adhikari and Uttam Adhikari discussed in the previous mantra, no one can actually correctly see spiritual position of a living being. It's not possible. We cannot hover on the mental platform for a long time. So other than somebody who is really on a Madhyama stage or Uttama stage, not possible. So Srila Prabhupada has said that simply read my books and repeat what I have written, then your preaching will be perfect. Okay, don't imagine. Ekatvam anupashyataha. Prabhupada uses this word. Ekatvam means oneness in quality. Quality, not quantity. Anupashyataha, of one who sees through authority or one who sees constantly like that. It indicates that one should see the unity of all living entities from the viewpoint of the revealed scriptures through authorities. We cannot fanatically combine everyone. Unity in diversity is a very nice concept, but it has to be taken from a spiritual vision. That yes, we are all united as unanimously agreeing upon as part and parcel of Krishna. So if we are all having that same father, then our duty is to serve him. That viewpoint, that is what Ekatva Manupashita means, that oneness in quality. Qualitatively, we are one. Qualitatively, we are one with Krishna also. Quantitatively, Krishna is very big. We are very, very small. But Ekatvam, oneness in quality, does not mean that living being is equal in all respect to the Supreme Lord. No. A a great devotee, Mahabhagavata sees oneness in the sense that he sees everything as the energy of the Supreme Lord. Okay, Krishna is spiritual, Sachidananda Vigraha, and infinite. We are infinitesimal. There is a word, Vibhu and Anu. We are Anu. Anu means very, very small, and Krishna is Vibhu, very, very big. So qualitatively, Krishna has Sachidananda Vigraha, Sachidananda feature. We also have soul-wise Sachidananda feature, but we have very small amount of it. There'll be more examples. Jiva Goswami coined the Achintya Bheda Bheda Tattva. Bheda means different, Abheda means non-different. Mane, we are non-different from Krishna in the sense that we also have Sachidananda feature, but we are at the same time different than Krishna because Krishna is a supreme, very, very supreme. And we are very, very small. Okay, so qualitatively, one, because we are part and parcel of Krishna, everyone, Garbhadakshaya Vishnu, Shirdakshaya Vishnu, Mahavishnu, or any other living entity. Qualitatively, we are Sachidanand. That is our real constitutional position. Individual souls or sparks of the Supreme Whole possess almost 80% of the known qualities of the whole, but they are not quantitatively equal to him. These qualities are present in minute quantity for the living entity, but is a minute part and parcel of the Supreme Whole. Okay. The qualities are present. There are more examples coming. There are three examples given in this chapter to explain this particular aspect, that how we are qualitatively one with Krishna, but quantitatively we are different. Oneness and difference at the same time. The sense of oneness is there since there is no difference between energy and energetic. They are the same. Okay. Although from analytical point of view, heat and light are different from the fire, but there is no meaning to the word fire without heat and light. Correct? So in synthesis, therefore, heat, light and fire are the same. So without heat and light, the fire has no meaning. The word fire, whenever is used, it automatically means that there is heat, there is light. But we can say that heat and light are the energy of fire. The origin of heat and light is fire. Our analogies of oneness and different. Quantity of salt in an ocean drop is never comparable to the quantity of salt present in the complete ocean. But the salt present in the drop is qualitatively equal to chemical composition of all the salt present in the ocean, right? If I want to analyze the quality of the salt present in this particular ocean, I can take a sample, a little bit, and study in the lab. So this will tell me all the salt content and the quality of salt in the entire ocean. But quantitatively, a drop is different than the whole ocean. That's one analogy. Second analogy used is, sparks of fire are qualitatively one with fire, but the quantity of heat and light present in the spark is not equal to that of fire. Okay, so ocean drop, the drop of ocean, even though qualitatively can tell me the characteristics of the whole ocean, but quantitatively is very, very incomparable. Sparks of fire also have heat and light, but they have such small amount of it, but the whole fire has a lot of it. Third example given is the family or nation. Although its members are different individual, they have the same interest. You know, Prabhupada gives example. Let's say somebody is staying in a foreign country and they meet the person of their own country. Let's say I'm from India and I'm walking on the road and I meet another Indian. I feel a sense of oneness that we are from the same country, right? So there's a sense of oneness that, okay, yes, I'm from here. Where are you from? Like that. So although its members are different individual, but they have the same interest. The interest is the same nation, or in the case of a family, the family. Since the living entities are members of the same supreme family, their interest and that of the supreme being are not different. Our only interest is Krishna's interest. In that way, we all belong to the family of Krishna. So if we all belong to the family of Krishna, then we are qualitatively one in our mission to serve Krishna. So our only interest is Krishna's interest. This is a constitutional position of a living entity. There are two dharmas. One is conditional, one is constitutional. Constitutional means that particular service which I give to the soul. And this is the service to the soul, that yes, my interest is in Krishna, your interest is in Krishna. Okay, everywhere. Spiritual entities are meant for enjoyment. We are never bhokta, we are bhukta. Bhukta means to be enjoyed, and bhokta means who enjoys. That is the reason why Krishna made us. As stated in Vedanta Sutra, first canto, second chapter, text number 12, Anandamaya Abhyashat. By nature and constitution, every living being, including the Supreme Lord and each of his parts and parcel, is meant for eternal enjoyment. Okay, every one of us have a tendency to enjoy, even though I'm so small, but my tendency to be happy is limitless. It's limitless. There is no measure. There's no measurement that we can put. There's no measurement that we can put as to how much happy I'm going to be. Correct? Can we put a measurement? Okay, we try to put a measurement to how much stress I have to face, how much more suffering, Krishna, how much more suffering, right? We say that, how much more suffering? You can write to me in the chat. Don't we say that? How much more coronavirus? When is this thing going to end? Don't we ask that? But if somebody is given a position to be happy, they don't ask that to Krishna, how much more happy? We are unlimitedly happy. There is no measurement, no mathematical unit can measure that amount of happiness, because that is my constitutional position, because I'm supposed to be happy. By nature, I am happy. Why? Because my source is happy. Okay, so if anyone who is around Krishna, anybody, or who is around a pure devotee of Krishna, can feel that spiritual happiness. Why do we feel so happy when we hear Prabhupada? Why? Or when we hear the Harinam, why do we feel so happy? Because it is spiritual vibration. It gives the happiness to the soul. Okay, Krishna means happiness, no distress at all. The living entities engaged in the material tabernacle are constantly seeking enjoyment, but on a wrong platform. We want to be happy, but we are looking in a wrong direction. Okay, so this is given in 13th chapter Bhagavad Gita, verse 22. The living entity in material nature thus follows the ways of life, enjoying the three modes of nature. This is due to his association with that material nature. Thus he meets with good and evil among various species. So we are trying to be happy in the modes of nature, material nature, goodness, passion, ignorance, and that will never make me happy. It may give me a little bit of a happiness here and there, but it's not going to stay. It's not going to stay. Very soon, the distress will come, and then happiness and distress. But spiritual happiness means happiness, happiness and happiness. Okay, how do we enjoy? By being nirguna, without material qualities, on that platform, Supreme Being enjoys himself with his innumerable associates. Okay, nirguna does not mean that no form. Nirguna, guna means material modes, or guna also means rope. And nir means no. So not under the modes of material nature is the correct understanding of word nirguna. Word nirguna is misunderstood. Mayavadi said guna means form, so no form is nirguna, so God has no form. But that's bogus. Guna means modes of nature. Nir means no. No sattagun, no rajagun, no tamagun. Then only shuddha sattva. Not material qualities, without material qualities. On that platform, Supreme Being enjoys himself with his innumerable associates. There is never a clash over the object of enjoyment, since the real center of enjoyment is the Supreme Lord. There's no competition that Krishna is God for 4 years and after that his job, his position is out there for the vote. It's not like that. And it's not like that that Krishna is God only for so-called Hindus. No, Krishna says, I am God. Aham sarvasya prabhavo matta sarvam pravartate iti matva bhajante mam bhura bhav samanvita. He says, I'm the source of everything. Everything, not only on earth, but upper, lower, planetary system, all universe. He's not saying I'm Hindu God, I'm Muslim God. He's saying I'm God, period. Period, nothing. The God is only one. Everyone else is just trying to approach Krishna through different ways, but Krishna is Krishna. That's it. We are all meant to join him and enjoy life with one transcendental interest and without any clash. We have to put Krishna in the center. Krishna, how can I serve you? And then through that, we enjoy. But what are we doing? How can Krishna be the enjoyer? That is envy. How can Krishna be the enjoyer? I should be the one enjoying independent of Krishna. Okay, then try. At least in this creation, 155 trillion years have passed. We have not succeeded. You want to stay here? My Guru Maharaj says, that we this place is such that one can live here as long as long as one wants. He says like this, as long as one wants, one can stay in this material world. Keep on staying. This body, that body, this. Or if you don't want to stay here, then also there is a way out. Okay, this is the highest platform of spiritual interest. As soon as one realizes this perfect of oneness, there's no question of illusion and lamentation. There's no question of illusion. Illusion means identity crisis. Lamentation means I am sad at times. I'm in shock. Why? Nothing. Okay, Bhagavad Gita 5.29, Krishna himself says that who is the enjoyer? Only enjoyer. Not enjoyer, only enjoyer. What is the verse? Does anyone know 5.29 verse? Does anybody know what the verse is? Somebody is trying to unmute themselves. Yes, Anvaya Mataji, you know the verse?
Mataji, it's Bhoktaram Yadnya Atapasam.
Please say. Sarvaloka Maheshwaram.
It's not...
Bhuktaram Yagna Tapasam Sarvaloka Maheshwaram. Then Suhridam Sarvabhutanam Gyatva Mam Shantim Ratchati. So a person in full consciousness of me, knowing me to be the ultimate beneficiary of all sacrifices and austerities, the supreme lord of all planets and demigods, the benefactor and well-wisher of all living entities, attains peace from the pangs of material miseries. That person alone. There is nobody else who can be 100% peaceful other than a Maha Bhagavata who has surrendered to Krishna. Krishna, you, only you, tam ekam. And Krishna says, mam ekam, and a devotee says, tvam ekam. There is no confusion. Okay, everybody, and Krishna wants everybody. Okay, so 7th chapter, 14th verse in Bhagavad Gita. No one but those who surrender at the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord can surpass the stringent laws of nature. Thus, if we want to get rid of illusion and anxiety and create unity out of diverse interests, we must bring God in our activities. Serving his interest only, then we can perceive the Atmabhuta interest. This is another one, Atmabhuta and Brahmabhuta. Atmabhuta means what is really my real self-interest, my real identity, and what is going to make me really happy, undeviated, unflinching happiness and safety and security that we look for, deathlessness. Atmabhuta and Brahmabhuta, actually they are same. Atmabhuta mentioned here is the same as Brahmabhuta interest mentioned in Bhagavad Gita 18.54. Supreme Atma or soul is the Lord himself and the minute Atma is a living entity. Okay, so 18.54 says, one who is thus transcendently situated at once realizes the Supreme Brahman and becomes fully joyful. He never laments nor desires to have anything. He is equally disposed toward every living entity. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me. See, so it's the same. So the Supreme Atma or Paramatma alone maintains all living, all the individual minute beings. For the Supreme Lord wants to derive pleasure out of their affection, like the father who extends himself through his children and maintains them in order to derive pleasure. Obedience to the father will give oneness and pleasure. Okay, so let's say a father has 3-4 children. He wants to maintain all of them. He doesn't want to ignore anybody. But why? Because he derives pleasure. There's a pleasure element. There's a motivation. If there is no motivation, why would a father maintain? Or why would a person even want to become a father if they don't want to have enjoyment in the association of their expansions? Similarly, Krishna wants us to enjoy with him. But now we are sitting here trying to enjoy without him. All right, question. Living entities enjoying with Krishna. What pastime is this? You can write to me in the chat. What is happening here? How are the living entities? So much of calamity was going on in this particular Leela. Yes, Govardhan Leela. So much. Indra sent Samvartaka cloud. Samvartaka cloud is sent when there is a need for devastation. The whole Vrindavan was in water. Everything was water. But what is happening here under the Govardhan Parvat? Krishna is holding with his left small finger, left side that too. What is happening? Do they look in distress? No. they were dancing, cooking food, and looking at Krishna. Nothing, no botheration. This is what our future is. Okay, what pastime is this? What is happening here? What pastime is this? Okay, I'm just going to lower all the hands and then we can all chat. Okay, and then you can raise your hands again. But I remember Priyadarshana Mataji will read first. I'm just going to please lower your hands for once, all of you, so I can see whose hand is lady up. Zero out. Okay, now raise your hand. What pastime is this? Yes, Vandana Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Mataji, it is Aghasur.
Yes, Aghasur are the snake demon. See, they Krishna told them, don't go. This is a snake. Don't go, don't go. The boys, Krishna, you are there. Anyway, we are going to take our chances. Now, Krishna has to worry how to save them. Prabhupada says that devotees of Krishna are fearless because they know Krishna will take care. Krishna has some anxiety how to take care of them. Imagine a pure devotee can put God in anxiety. We are full of anxiety because we are disconnected from our source. Connect yourself back. What pastime is this? Yes, what pastime is this? Yes, Meenakshi Mataji. Oh, she lowered her hand. Yes, Meenakshi Mataji, what pastime is this?
Mataji, I think it is Bakasura.
Very nice. Bakasura. So they all the Vrindavan Vasis became almost lifeless because Bakasura, the bird demon, swallowed Krishna. Right? See they, how lifeless they are. They are falling on the ground because Krishna is invisible. How many of us are doing like this? Because Krishna is invisible from my vision, I'm falling on the ground unconscious. And we claim that we are God or we are pure devotees of God. That's rubbish. Okay, but Krishna said, okay, don't worry. You want me, I'm back here. And then he killed Bakasura. Okay, what pastime is this? This is a little bit difficult. Who has read Krishna book? What pastime is this? Roshan, Hare Krishna. Yes, Roshan, what pastime is this?
Yes, it is Varun Deva pastime. Vasudeva was taken by Varun Deva.
Correct, thank you. Yes, this is in 10th Krishna book that Vasudev Vasudev or Nand Maharaj? I'm confused now. Was it Vasudev or Nand Maharaj? Yes, Nand Vandana Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Mataji Nand Maharaj.
Nand Maharaj, right? Yes, because he broke his Ekadashi. Yes, thank you, Mataji. So he wanted to break his Ekadashi. So he wanted to take bath in the water. But he entered the water at a wrong time. So there are times to take bath also. Because he entered the water in the wrong time, he was caught by Varuna. So Krishna came to save. Krishna came to save Nand Maharaj. Okay, so we will go over this. Priyadarshini Mataji, you can raise your hand so I can see you. Where is she? Priyadarshini Mataji, please unmute yourself. You can read. Mataji, your audio is not proper. Mataji, please check your audio.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Okay, Hare Krishna. Priyadarshini Mataji, oh, you're muted. Mataji, unmute yourself, please.
Can you hear me, Mataji?
Mataji, no. Please check your audio settings. Your voice is cracking.
Am I audible now?
Say again.
Am I audible?
You're audible, but your voice is not clear. It's breaking. So please check it and then come back. Leena Bhatt, Mataji. Yes, Mataji, go ahead.
Yasmin Sarvani Bhutani. Atmaiva bhudvijanataha tatra ko mohaka soka ekatvam anupasyata. One who always sees all living entities as spiritual sparks in quality one with the Lord becomes a true knower of things. What is there as illusion or anxiety for him? Purport. Except for the two more advanced devotees described above, no one can correctly see the spiritual position of a living being. The living entities are qualitatively one with the Supreme Lord, as the sparks of the fire are qualitatively one with the nature of the fire, but sparks are not fire as far as quantity is concerned. The quantity of heat and light present in the fire is not equal to the quantity of heat and light in the sparks. The Mahabhagavata, the great devotee, sees oneness in the sense that everything is the energy of the Supreme Lord, as there is no difference between the energy and the energetic. There is the sense of oneness between, without heat and light, there is no meaning of fire. And yet, heat and light from the analytical point of view are different from fire. But in synthesis, heat, light, and fire are all the same one thing.
Thank you, Mataji. So, Mahabhagavata sees that. Me, God, and Mahabhagavata can't stop but see other than God. The Mahabhagavata sees nothing other than Krishna, and other challenging mentalities say, show me God. See, such a diverse vision, right? That they say, show me God. And here is a pure devotee's vision that they see nothing other than God. Nothing. So except for the two more advanced devotees, which mean Madhyam Adhikari and Uttam Adhikari, no one can actually correctly see the position of a living entity. No one. The living entity is qualitatively one, but not quantitatively one. Okay, and the example given in this or analogy given is a fire and spark of fire. So spark of fire also has heat and light, but it is small in amount, but qualitatively it has heat and light. Okay, and then we're going to read about Ekadvam Anupashyataha. Lakshmi Nishthala Mataji, you can unmute.
The Sanskrit, hello, Hare Krishna Mataji. Hello. The Sanskrit words found here, Ekatvam Anupashyata, means to see the unity of the living entities from the viewpoint of the revealed scriptures. Every individual spark of the Supreme Whole has almost 80% of the known quantities of the whole, but they are not as good as the Supreme Lord. The qualities are present in the minute quantity, as the living entity is but a minute part and parcel of the whole Supreme Whole. This is like the drop of water and the ocean. The quantity of salt present in the drop is never comparable to the quantity of salt present in the complete ocean. But the quality of the salt present in the drop is equal in quality, in chemical composition, with that present in the ocean. If the individual being were equal in quality and quantity, then there would be no question of the living entities being submerged by the influence of material energy. It has already been discussed in the previous mantras that no living being, even the powerful demigods, can surpass the Supreme Being in any respect. Therefore, Ekatvam does not mean that a living being is equal in all respects with the Supreme Lord. It means, in a broader sense, that there is one interest, just as in the family, the interest of all members is one. In a nation, although different individual citizens are there, the national interest is one. Therefore, the living entities being parts and parcels of the Supreme Family, the interest of the Supreme Being and that of the parts and parcel is not different. Every living being is the son of the Supreme Being. As it is said in the Bhagavad Gita, all living creatures, including birds, reptiles, ants, aquatics, trees, and so on, all over the universe, are the emanations from the marginal potency of the Supreme Lord. And therefore, all of them belong to the same family of the Supreme Being. There is no clash in the interest in the spiritual life.
Yes, thank you, Mataji. Let's understand. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Nicely read. So Ekatvam Anupashyataha means to see unity of a living and of the living entities from the viewpoint of the revealed scriptures. That is actually a unity. No one else can actually see any unity in anyone other than the spiritual sense. Otherwise, you see, the government laws are very imperfect. They say, who's a citizen of a country? Who's born in that country? Generally, that's the citizen definition of a citizen. That if I am born in India, so I'm by birth citizen of India, right? But the government laws are so imperfect. Or if I'm born in America, then I'm American citizen or any country. But the government laws are so imperfect that they give protection to the human being born as a citizen, but then they send the animal which is born as a citizen to the slaughterhouse. Why is the definition of citizenship only limited to the human beings? Okay, why is it only limited to the human beings? Because they don't have ekadvam anupashyatah vision. They don't have the spiritual unanimity. They don't. Okay, so don't get taken over by false promises of anybody around you, because one has to promise the spiritual unity. So Prabhupada has brought this. So that is why a devotee of Krishna does not like to give problem to anybody, not even a small ant. Why? Its life is important because Krishna has placed it there. Okay, every individual spark of the human being has almost 80% of the known qualities of the whole. But they're not as good as the Supreme, but they're not as good as the Supreme Lord. It's like spark of fire has a little bit of a heat and a little bit of a light, but you can't cook a meal out of it. Can you cook a meal out of a spark of fire, or you need the whole fire? What do you need? You can write to me in the chat. What do you need to cook a meal? Do you want a complete fire, or you want a spark of fire, which also has heat and light? Correct, the whole fire, not the spark of fire. So in the same way, I need the whole Krishna. I need to go to Krishna. Yes, we can assist each other in our journey. We can assist. We can associate with each other with the same interest. But one has to go through their own journey alone at the end. Okay, there is assistance. But there is also an individuality. Because I belong to Krishna, Krishna consciousness is very personal, very, very personal. Krishna consciousness is the most personal thing that anyone can ever have in their life. We look for personal life, right? Personal. What is so personal? Whatever is happening in someone's life is so common. It's happening in every other life. But only different thing, only real personal thing to a living entity is the relationship of that soul with Krishna. Each one of us have an individual relation with Krishna. Read Brihad Bhagavatamrita. See how Krishna is waiting. We think Krishna has so many souls so he can forget. See how Krishna is desperate. So the other example is drop of water in the ocean. So we can study the drop of ocean and study the salt content, and then this will tell me quality of the salt, and this will tell me the quality of the salt in the whole thing. So study the quality of the soul, and then you can understand the quality of the super soul, but in just manifold in quantity. Third example is family and nation. That family in all the members of the family, even though different individuals, but they work towards a common interest of family's growth, right? Or all the citizens of the country, even though they are different individuals, but they work towards the growth and development of the nation together. So the interest is same. Like that, every single living entity, even though in different bodies, different places, can also serve with a common interest of serving Krishna. And that is unity in diversity. That is unity in diversity. I have spoken to you guys about the book called Invisible String, and there is no clash of interest in spiritual life. No one is trying to be Krishna. Everyone wants to be the servant of the servant of the servant of Krishna. The Invisible String, I think I have spoken, right? My admins, I have spoken about this book, right? The Invisible String. Bidisha Mataji, have you heard of it?
Yes, Mataji, you have mentioned it earlier. Hare Krishna,
Mataji. Hare Krishna. Yes, the Invisible String, like we are all connected to a string which is invisible. I am connected to you, you are connected to the next person next to you, then another next person. This string goes all over the world, all over the planets. And what is this connection made of? By connection is made of belonging to Krishna. Okay, yes, Priyadarshini Mataji, you can go ahead.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Am I audible now, Mataji? Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. The spiritual entities are meant for enjoyment. By nature, by constitution, every living being, both the Supreme Lord, and each different part and parcel is meant for enjoyment eternally. The living beings who are engaged in the material tabernacle are also seeking enjoyment always. But they are seeking their enjoyment on a platform which is not meant for them. Aside from this material world, there is the spiritual platform where the Supreme Being is enjoying with his innumerable associates without any trace of material qualities. That platform is called Nirguna. On the Nirguna platform, there is no clash of enjoyment. Here in the material world, there is always a clash between different individual beings because here the center of enjoyment is missed. The center of enjoyment is the Supreme Lord, who is the center of the sublime and spiritual rasa, dance. We are all meant for enjoying him and for enjoying life with one transcendental interest and without any clash. That is the high platform of spiritual interest. And as soon as such a perfect form of oneness is realized, there can be no question of illusions or lamentation.
Thank you, Mataji. So we are all meant for joining him and for enjoying life with one transcendental interest and without clash. This is the meaning of my life. People are looking, they're so depressed. The whole world, mental diseases are outpowering that physical diseases, right? Why? Because they're missing the point. Missing the point that that I'm supposed to be enjoying with Krishna. All the mental disorders are from mode of ignorance. Mode of ignorance pulls us down. And mode of ignorance means more forgetfulness of Krishna. More. Yes, mode of goodness, there is some remembrance of Krishna. Someone is trying to elevate themselves by knowledge. Mode of passion, still okay. And ignorance is completely forget. Prabhupada gives example, spark of fire has three destinations. Let's say a spark of fire falls out of the fire and then it falls on a dry ground, dry grass. It falls on a dry grass. So that spark of fire can actually ignite the big fire in the dry grass, right? So that is mode of goodness. That, okay, I have this little bit of a tendency to gain knowledge. And if I get the proper knowledge and I start chanting, then complete, I get established in my constitutional position. The other future of the spark of fire is if it lands on a earth, on the ground. So if it lands on the earth, then it takes few minutes, but then it dissipates. That's Rajagun. If I don't put Krishna in my center, there is a tendency because passionate person is working. That's a quality. But if they go on working go away, and that work takes them away from Krishna, then that spark disappears. The third destination, he explains, is spark of fire falling in the water. Immediately dissipates. Immediately. So that is mode of ignorance. Mode of ignorance takes us away. Takes us completely away. Okay, so all these diseases of the mind are from mode of ignorance. And the only antidote really is to cultivate at least mode of goodness. And that can only happen if someone is chanting the sound vibration of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Otherwise, we go down and down and down. Yes, Vibha, you wanted to chant and then we can have Mataji. Asha Mataji chant. Read.
Yes, Mataji. Can I read, Mataji?
Yeah.
Maya or illusion means a godless civilization, the result of which is lamentation. The godless civilization sponsored by the modern politicians is always full of anxieties, and that is the law of nature. No one can surpass this law as is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Only those who surrender at the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord can overcome the stringent law of nature. If therefore we wish to get rid of all sorts of illusion and anxiety and create unity of all diverse interests, we must bring God into all our activities. The results...
Very nice. Thank you. So Maya or illusion means godless civilization. See, whenever the civilization that we are living in is called illusion, based on illusion, because civilization means shanti. Every citizen of a country, of the nation, should be able to have peace. This is a basic right to have proper education, proper housing, proper shelter, proper security, proper food. That is civilization that was happening in the realm of Rishta Maharaj or kings who were devotees of Krishna. We don't read all these problems in the civilization that was under such exalted kings. We don't, because it was not there. That's why we don't. But nowadays, you know, it's so godless that everyone wants to enjoy themselves. Everyone wants to enjoy themselves and no one wants to care for someone else. Why? Because we are missing the center point. We're missing the center point. If I feel that, okay, let's say that I'm a leader of the country and my consciousness is that this country belongs to Krishna. And that means the citizens of the country, all the living entities are Krishna's property. So I must take care of Krishna's property with utmost care. So will I be creating a havoc? Will I be creating a havoc? Such a leader, will that leader be creating a havoc? What do you think? Theoretically speaking, you can write to me in the chat. What do you think? Or my admins can tell me honestly. If a leader of the country or a leader of the family looks at the family. Am I audible? Because no one is writing. Okay. So if the leader of the family, there is a head of the household in every house. So if the head of the household is 100% devotee of Krishna, 100% devotee of Krishna, and that particular family member, the head of the family, looks at his subjects as part and parcel of Krishna and takes care of the family, is that family going to face any problem? Never.
No.
Ever. Never, ever. Even if there's going to be a problem, it's going to be an opportunity to increase the surrender and not an obstacle. There's a difference between opportunity and obstacle. A devotee of Krishna sees problem as an opportunity to serve Krishna more. Now Krishna has come in front of me as an obstacle. Let me make it as an opportunity. There's a lot of difference between what a Krishna conscious life can give us and what a material conscious life is giving us. Material conscious life is only giving us death. There's nothing else. Yes, Asha Mataji, you can read. The results of our activities.
Hare Krishna Mataji. The result of our activities must be used to serve the interest of the Lord and not for any other purpose. Because only by serving the interest of the Lord, we can feel the Atma Bhuta interest mentioned here in the Sri Isopanishad. This and the Brahma Bhuta interest mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita are one and the same thing. The Supreme Atma or soul is the Lord Himself and the minute Atma is a living entity. The Supreme Atma or Paramata alone maintains all the individual minute beings because the Supreme Lord wants to derive pleasure out of their affection. The Father extends Himself by His children and maintains them in order to derive pleasure. If the children of the father are obedient to his will, family affairs will run smoothly with one interest and a pleasing atmosphere. Exactly the same thing is transcendently arranged in the Brahman, or absolute family of the Parabrahman, the Supreme Spirit.
Very nice.
Hare Mataji, Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna. So again, Prabhupada is saying, we started the reading by the description of the life which is viewed from the vision of the two exalted devotees, Madhyamadhikari and Uttamadhikari. And then we discuss what is Evatmam Anupashyataha, that oneness in quality. And then Prabhupada explained it by giving three analogies that how oneness in quality, like a spark is qualitatively one with the fire. In the sense, spark also has heat and light, but quantitatively different. Then ocean, drop of ocean and the whole ocean. So drop of ocean has same quality as the of salt as the whole ocean, but quantitatively different. Or the interest of the family or the interest of the nation is, there may be different people in the family or different people in the nation, but they have the same interest. They have the same interest. And then we studied that Nirguna platform. What is Nirguna? Nirguna means Krishna consciousness gives us a happiness from transcendental goodness. Nirguna does not mean no form. Nirguna means no material quality. No material quality. And then third aspect Prabhupada explains is Atma Bhuta. Atma Bhuta or Brahma Bhuta are the same thing, that I belong to Krishna. This is my relationship. And then in that sense, I am supposed to serve Krishna. And by serving Krishna, I will enjoy. That is the definition of enjoyment from spiritual point of view. Sadanand Prabhu. Yes, Prabhuji. Param Brahman.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
The Param Brahman is as much a person as the individual entities are. None of them are impersonal. Such transcendental personalities are full of transcendental bliss, knowledge, and life eternal. That is the real position of spiritual existence. And as soon as one is fully cognizant of this transcendental position, he at once surrenders onto the lotus feet of the Supreme Being, Sri Krishna. But such Mahatmas, great souls, are very rarely seen, because such transcendental realization is achieved only after many, many births. Once attained, however, there is no more illusion or distress. No more of the mystery of material existence, and there is no birth and death as we experience in the present status of our life. This is the information we get from the mantra of Sri Ishwanupisad.
So nice, right? Once we get that Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Nashoshati Nakankshati. Thank you. Sama Sarveshu Bhuteshu Madbhakti Labhate Param. This is 18th chapter Bhagavad Gita, verse number 54. Sochati na kankshati. So unless and until we are sochati and kankshati, means we are hankering and we are lamenting and we are illusion, we are not on the Brahma Buddha platform. There is no point in faking. There is no point, because Krishna is sitting in the heart. Where else? Okay, I have questions. I have very interesting questions, but let's do questions first, and then I have a video to show. So please raise your hand. Explain the Ekatvam Anupashyataha. What does it mean? Ekatvam Anupashyataha. And the admins can actually unmute themselves. You can unmute yourself if you want to answer. Where is my PhD scholar? Khushbu? Yes. What is Ekatvam Anupashyataha?
Mataji, actually I had a doubt. So anyways, I'll tell you the meaning. It means to see the unity of the living entities from viewpoint of the revealed scriptures.
Very nice. Or qualitatively oneness. Very nice. Usha Mataji, yes, Mataji. What is Ekadvam Anupashyataha?
It is to see the oneness, qualitative oneness in everyone.
A qualitative oneness in everyone with what vision? Expand it, Mataji.
From the viewpoint which is revealed in the scriptures, Mataji.
Okay, thank you, Mataji. Girija Mataji, yes, what is Ekatvam Anupashyataha?
Yeah, it is to see the unity of all living entities from the scriptural point of view.
So what is that unity from the scriptural point of view? What is that? Can you expand it?
From one who sees it through the authority, the oneness of all qualities, which is their oneness of the qualities.
Okay, thank you, Mataji. Yes, Meenakshi Mataji.
Mataji, so it means to see the unity in all the living beings as per the scriptures, the revealed in the scriptures.
So what is revealed in the scriptures? What is the unity kind
that Supreme Lord, Supreme God is present in all the living beings as Paramatma. We are different, but qualitatively we are same. Like you gave some examples, drop of water is qualitatively same as the ocean water, but not quantitatively.
Correct. Thank you. Correct. That's a proper understanding. Okay. What is Achintya Bheda Bheda Tattva? Abheda. I think I wrote two A's. Sorry. So explain Achintya Bheda Bheda. What is the meaning of Bheda and Abheda? Is Madhuri Mataji not here today? Sorry. Madhuri Mataji, Hare Krishna. I'm sorry, I didn't see you. Yes, Madhuri Mataji, you can unmute yourself. Achintya Bheda Bheda Tattva.
Hare Krishna, Madhuri.
Hare Krishna.
Quantitatively, we are one with Krishna, but quantitatively, there's a lot of difference. So the examples are given like the fire and the sparks. Qualitatively, they are one. But quantitatively, there's a lot of difference. And the ocean, drop of ocean and the ocean itself. So
very nice.
80% of the qualities are seen in the living entities, but they are very minutely seen.
Okay. Very nice. Thank you, Mataji. Yes, Geeta Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. I thought the previous Mataji shared the same thing. Like Bheda, Bheda is different. Abheda is
not different.
Not different, correct. And as you had explained earlier, the drop of ocean, the drop of water in the ocean is not different from the entire ocean. Qualitatively, correct. Yeah. Qualitatively.
Correct. Thank you very much. And thank you for all those who are writing on the chat. Okay, Nirguna, explain Nirguna. Dyuti, where did she go? People who have answered and spoken, please let others have chance now. Shilpa Jha Mataji, yes. What is Shilpa Jha Mataji? What is Nirguna?
Nirguna is above the Trigunas, Sattva, Raja and Tama. So we call the Supreme Lord on the Nirguna as Nirguna.
Very nice. Thank you, Mataji. Shobha Malli Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Nir means no and Guna means all three modes of Gunas like Rajoguna, Tamoguna and Sattva Guna. Above all this is the Shuddha Sattva Guna. So this is, that's what I understood, Mataji.
Very nice. You understood and then you understood a little bit more also. So Nirguna is no material qualities.
No,
okay.
No material qualities.
Thank you.
Hare
Krishna. Perfect. Okay. What is Atma Bhuta? And explain Atma Bhuta and Brahma Bhuta. What does it mean? Vajanti Mataji.
Oh, Atma Bhuta, Brahma Bhuta. Hare Krishna Mataji. Atma Bhuta is say soul and Brahma Bhuta is super soul. Krishna is the only enjoyer and all other people are to be enjoyed by Krishna.
Okay, thank you, Mataji. Brahman also means living entity. Brahman does not only mean super soul. Yes, Dyuti.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Mataji, Atma Bhuta means real self. Though it is similar to Brahma Bhuta, and in chapter 7, 14th verse, as it is said, and Supreme Atma or Paramatma, you know, it alone maintains the individual minute beings. But we are obedient towards our Father. So like that, we need to be obedient towards Krishna and we need to be unified in our spiritual journey towards Krishna, though our individual journey varies from person to person. That's
okay.
What Mataji.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Shobha Malli Mataji and then Anvaya Mataji. Yes, Shobha Malli Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Atma Bhuta and Brahma Bhuta. Atma Bhuta means living entities where we are very small compared to Brahma Bhuta. That is Anu Atma and Vibhu Atma. Anu Atma is compared living entities. We are living entities. We are very small compared to the Vibhu Atma. So it's very big. And this is very minute.
De Sante.
Okay, thank you, Mataji. Anvaya Mataji.
Mataji, Atma Bhuta and Brahma Bhuta are the same. They refer to the Supreme Atma or the Paramatma who maintains all the individuals. That is my understanding.
Correct. That is what is written here. So I think people are getting confused in this Atma Bhuta and Brahma Bhuta. See, over here, Prabhupada is talking about it. this Atma Bhuta, Brahma Bhuta, where does it say? One second. The results of our activities must be used to serve the interests of the Lord and not for any other purpose, because only by serving the interests of the Lord can we feel Atma Bhuta interest mentioned here in Upanishad. This and the Brahma Bhuta interest mentioned in Bhagavad Gita are one and the same thing. Okay, everybody is a little bit here, there, everywhere about this. So, this Krishna, this Brahma Bhuta interest mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, this and Brahma Bhuta interest mentioned in Bhagavad Gita are one and the same thing. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. My fine motor skills are not too good. One and the same thing. Okay. So same, there's no difference. The supreme Atma or soul is the Lord himself and minute Atma is a living entity. Last question, what are the three analogies used in mantra? What are the three analogies which are used in this mantra to explain the oneness and difference? Yes, very quickly. Rupa Mataji, do you want to say what are the three analogies used in this mantra? Rupa Mataji. Dr. Parikh. Yes, Dr. Parikh.
First analogy is a spark and a fire. Hmm. Second analogy is a drop from an ocean and the ocean. Hmm. And third analogy is national or family.
Interest as a common. They have the same interest, it's even though they're different.
The common.
Very nice. Thank you, Dr. Parikh. Uma Thank Mataji. You. Yes, Mataji.
First is a drop of ocean and the ocean. Mm. Second is spark of fire and the fire. Mm. Third is member of a family and the family.
Very nice. Thank you. My admins, Bidisha Mataji.
What is Hare Krishna Mataji. The fire and the spark, the family and the nation. And the third is just a second, Mataji. Just skip my mind. I'm sorry, Mataji.
Fire and
ocean and the drop of water, the ocean water. The okay, whole of the ocean and the drop of ocean.
Thank
you. Hare Krishna, Mataji.
So everyone, please try to read before you come for the class. These mantras are not very big. Okay, we can take some... Oh, no, we cannot take some questions yet. We have to watch Prabhupada's video. One second. I have one Prabhupada's video to show. This is Prabhupada's interview with a social worker in Australia, Melbourne.
Let's take you back to 1975. Where he has a discussion with a social worker.
Minister is elected according to the Queen of Society.
Yeah, because they have made a department just like your day. What is the department?
Social welfare.
Social welfare. So if they find social welfare, why not help? Why they bring politics? If actually there is social welfare here, why they should not support it?
Yeah, well, you're right. But in our society, minister is elected to carry out certain policies. Not what he wants, but what the people sort of voted for. And say a text to support.
And if your policy is social reformation.
Social reform is not our policy.
The social welfare.
So just to look after those who are in trouble. Mm-hmm. That's our policy.
Well, everyone is in trouble.
What?
At the present moment, even the ministers are in trouble.
Yes, but that is not what our function is. Everybody's in trouble.
Physician, healed thyself. You see? They are also drunkards. They are also woman hunters. And meat eaters and gambling. That's all. They require to be rectified.
But it can help that. That society. You have to go and change society. The society tells us to act.
Unless you change the society, how you can make social welfare?
Well,
if you keep them as it is, there is a question of welfare.
give it a different interpretation to the word.
I don't
understand me.
Basically, basically, one must be first class ideal man.
Yeah.
That is one.
That's why it's so very difficult. You have to work on your own, and only have to see that you have freedom to work. But if you convince enough people to go your
own. Our own program, it is not boxed properly. You find out fault with us.
What?
You find out what is our fault.
I can't see any fault.
Then you can disagree. But when you see everything is nice, how you will not accept it? Unless you are biased.
Of course I'm biased. I've been brought up differently.
Yes. That's like our...
That is your bias against my life.
No, we are not biased. We
you
say
that
just
saying.
Like we are not biased. We are allowing. We say that if you want to be first class man, then you must not commit sinful activities.
Hmm.
That is our problem.
But I as a public servant, I'm not here to change society. Society
we are also public.
What
we
to
are,
do?
We belong to the public. You must become our servant also.
Yeah. What?
We are public, members of the public.
Yeah.
So you should become our servant also, if you are public servant.
A public servant is in our philosophy, is a man who serves a minister elected by the people. It's this way he serves. Serves the public.
Yeah.
And what the public decides,
it
votes accordingly.
We are informing the public. Just like we are proposing here. I'm not proposing. Krishna says that one must be peaceful. But how to become peaceful? If his mind is always disturbed, how he can become peaceful?
You're quite right.
So that is the secret of success. You want to make people peaceful, but you do not know how to make him peaceful.
Yeah.
So therefore, you have to adopt this.
You have a competitive society.
Yeah. We say that you chant Hare Krishna, eat here sumptuously, live here comfortably, and you become peaceful.
Mm.
It is guaranteed. If anyone, even a madman agrees to this principle, that let him chant Hare Krishna mantra, take whatever nice food stuff we prepare, take, and live peacefully. He will be peaceful.
What's your answer that still such a small percentage of the population, tiny percentage of the population,
no.
Except the philosophy that sounds so...
Tiny percentage, just like... There are so many stars in the sky,
yeah.
And there is one moon. In percentage, the moon is nothing. If you take percentage of the stars, the moon is nothing. But moon is important than all the nonsense stars. But if you take percentage, there is no percentage both. But because he is moon, he is important than all these rascal stars. This is the example.
Yeah, well,
what is the use of taking percentage of the stars in the presence of moon? Let there be one moon, that is sufficient. There is no question of percentage. One ideal man. Just like in Christian world, one ideal Jesus Christ.
How do you feel about Mao Zedong?
Huh? What is that?
This is how you feel about Mao Zedong.
In China, he's an ideal man.
He's a communist.
His ideal is all right.
In China, he is.
His ideal, communist idea, that everyone should be happy. That is good idea. But they do not know how to make it. Just like they are taking care of the human being in the state, but they are sending poor animals to this letter. So, for the satisfaction of the tongue of the human being, the animal should be cut through. That is the defect.
A minister regards himself as a servant of the people who can be kicked out in
that
the
That is the tongue. Defect. The people are rascals and they have elected another rascal. That is the defect.
Well, but that's how it is.
What can be them. Then hopeless.
Oh, you can work on the
crash. We are going without depending on this rascal. Yes. We are going on.
Sorry about it. So nice, right? There's no confusion. No illusion, no two. Okay, if you have a question, please, you can unmute yourself or raise your hand. Dyuti, you have a question?
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Yeah, Mataji, I have one question actually. Mataji, according to Vaishnava calendar, when do we need to follow Shivaratri fasting, Mataji? Is it on Thursday or Friday?
I don't know. It's an out of the course question you're asking me right now. Look at the Vaishnava calendar.
Okay, Mataji.
I don't know right now. My calendar is hanging on the wall over there. So
okay, Mataji, no problem. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. There's a website. Oh, by the way, I can really help you. Yes, because there's a website called Vaishnava Calendar. Dyuti, are you there? You can unmute yourself. Dyuti.
Yes, Mataji, I'm there.
There's this website, Vaishnava Calendar in Vaishnava. Calendar, this one, okay. Info. Vaishnava calendar.info. Okay, and then you can choose which part of the world are you in.
Okay, Mataji.
And look at it. You're in Calcutta, right?
Yes, Mataji, Kolkata.
So you choose your place. I don't see Kolkata here. Anyway, this is what the...
No problem.
Hi Krishna. Girija Mataji.
Yeah, Hare Krishna Mataji. I have a doubt between Achintya Veda and Abhedya Tattva.
Okay.
What is it? Like I didn't get it properly. Vedya and Veda. What is it?
Yes, who's going to explain her? Rupa Mataji, will you please explain her what is Achintya Veda, Abhedya Tattva?
Yes, Mataji. It's like Krishna is everywhere, yet he is independent. In simple words.
Okay. Thank you.
He's like, yeah.
Anyone else? Seema Mataji, would you like to say something? Achintya Bheda Bheda Tattva. Mataji, it means that I am simultaneously one with Krishna, but simultaneously I'm different than Krishna. So qualitatively, I am one with Krishna. Krishna is Sachidananda, right? So he's eternal and he's full of knowledge and he's full of bliss. I, in the soul level, also have Sachidananda feature. But I am at the same time different because I am not as big as Krishna. As much as spark of a fire has a heat and light, but it's not so much that it's as it is present in the main fire. But qualitatively it is one, but at the same time it is different.
So in these two words, this Bheda is, that is what I'm trying to get. Which is the one for the oneness with the qualitatively?
Bheda means one in oneness and Abheda means different.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Khushbu Mataji, Khushbu.
Yes, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
So young. Hare Krishna.
Mataji, my doubt is that first of all, this has been a little difficult mantra for me to understand. Like the previous mantras were like quite giving straightforward information about what exactly the mantra is stating. But this mantra is giving a lot of information. So my question is, what exactly is the essence of this mantra?
Prabhupada says that in the last paragraph, what is the essence of this mantra? Last line is this is the essence of this mantra.
Mataji, I didn't understand that.
Once attained, however, there's no more illusion or distress, no more misery of material existence, there's no more birth, death as we experience in the present. This is the information we get from this mantra of Aishupanishad, that I am qualitatively one with Krishna. I don't belong anywhere else. You see, let's say that there is a person loitering on the street. What is your question going to be when you see them? Baba, kahan ja rahe ho? Right? That is your question going to be. Where are you going? Where do you belong? And the person says, I don't know where I belong. That's why I'm trying to find out where I belong. So that is that particular person that is obviously insane. But we are all insane because we don't know where we belong. That is why we are changing bodies. Okay, let me become a male now. Let me become a woman now. Let me become a child now. Let me become a cow now. Let me become a goat now. Let me become fish now. Because I don't know where I belong. Once you find out where you belong, you're not going to change your status. You belong there. But we have not figured that out yet. We are still in the process of figuring out. People change career, right? Okay, maybe this is not a job where I fit in. And then, okay, then another, maybe this is not the job where I fit. Or people change relationships. Maybe this is not. So many changing. Because what are we looking for? We are looking for our belongingness. Where do I really belong? So we really belong to Krishna. And then once we actually realize that, then I don't have to go through all this changing anymore. I don't have to really. Let's say you're shopping for a dress in the store. Okay? And then you're trying out dresses. Trying out. Until when are you going to try out until you find a dress that really fits you and that you really like?
Yes.
Correct? So then your tryout will be done. Then you're going to buy that and go home, right?
Yes.
Like that, we are trying out. we are trying out. Okay. Okay, maybe this. Okay, maybe now I see something on your chin. If I say something, maybe I should put a hole there. Maybe I should put it on the umbilicus. Maybe 10 holes on the ear. Well, okay, then how much? We have to stop somewhere. Did you get the point that we have to understand where we belong? And we have to stop this business of finding out our belongingness. People are suffering from one disease across the world, and that disease is called loneliness. People are very lonely. But here Prabhupada is saying, Krishna is sitting right in your heart. What, you're lonely? We have no time. You come here, eat prasadam, chant Hare Krishna, live a comfortable life. No, I want to be lonely because I don't belong there. Oh, I don't belong to ISKCON. Okay, good luck. Then you belong to your loneliness. If you don't belong here, then you belong somewhere. Let's say that I'm sitting on this chair, okay? And now I'm going to get up and then go and sit in another chair in the other part of my house. So what will I say? Oh, I don't belong to this chair. Let me get up and let me go to another one. Finally, I have to sit somewhere. Finally, I'll say, okay, this is okay. I belong here. वैसे हम अपनी belongingness ढूंढ रहे हैं, ढूंढते जा रहे हैं. Okay. The mode of ignorance, if we go on finding our belongingness in the mode of ignorance, then we go away from Krishna, so far away, and then we get more lonely. Animals are lonely. If you really study, human beings are not lonely. Animals are lonely. They are lonely. Even some animals, their mother after birth gives them up. Why? Because couldn't figure out. Pata hi nahi chala.
Yes. Okay, Mataji. I understood.
Okay.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. Thank you. Gita, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. I think you have partly answered my question, but nevertheless, I'm going to ask you this. In the video, we just saw Prabhuji saying... Prabhupada saying that... our mind has to be peaceful. He was quoting to that. But unknowingly, knowingly many a times, and unknowingly, your mind gets very disturbed. As you rightly said, you feel lonely or whatever. There are a lot of disturbances in our mind. In spite of getting into these chanting and many other things that we involve into our day-to-day life. But still, there are areas and there are times when we are not able to control these factors. It shows out somewhere. I would like to know how to go about with this, because this has to help me. You know, this will help me if you answer me.
Yes, me too. Actually, I was looking for the answer too. But one, Mataji, Radha Devi Rasi, she's a criminal lawyer in California, but she's from Harvard. She's very educated. I heard her class. She answered my question. She said, yes, because we're in a conditional life, we are not looking at Paramatma all the time. That is why we should never be alone in Krishna consciousness. We should never be alone in Krishna consciousness. You should always have a companion. Either you should have a friend, or your husband has to be a devotee of Krishna, or something. Somebody has to be there. Okay, it's going to be a two of tango of two people, minimum. So one is going down, other will pull up. Or more than two is more the merrier. It's fine. As long as everyone has the same self-interest, same interest. Okay, Mataji, because once we are conditioned, we are not chanting Hare Krishna from Shuddha Sattva platform. There are three levels of chanting. We feel that. Why? Because we are not chanting properly. And we are still in the process of getting purified. So we need each other. We really need each other. I am happiest when I am in the class.
Correct.
I'm honestly Mataji. Telling.
Absolutely.
I'm happiest. The minute the class is done, I start looking at, oh my God, so many other things are there.
The external factors start influencing you the moment you quit this class, you know.
As long as you don't go on practicing. Mataji, that is first test. I remember when I am 19 years ago, when I used to go to temple in Mangalore on Sunday evenings. And Prabhu, we used to have roaring kirtan. Mangalore, 3 hour, no less than 2-3 hour kirtan. Not like half an hour kirtan, we are done. No, 2-3 hours we used to dance on Sunday feast. Sometimes I used to feel while in the middle of the kirtan, why so long? But I didn't want to go. So go on. I have experienced it. Go on. And at the end, when the kirtan is done, I feel in the middle, I'm feeling tired. But at the end, I'm feeling like, wow, this is so amazing. And when I used to walk back to the hostel, I used to feel so low. 2-3 days, I remember Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, comes Wednesday, I'm back again. So I need charging again. So we are like that. We are like that. That's why we need constant association, constantly burning in fire, constantly having some service or the other to Krishna. Actually, if you feel sad after leaving the hearing about Krishna, it means you're making a progress because you want to come back to it, right?
Yes, Mataji.
So that means that your soul is hankering. Come back. Just come back. Just don't leave. Come back. So that's actually a good sign. And eventually you'll be blessed that you'll be placed in a very thick. So keep on feeling like that, but also work on it. Don't succumb to it.
Yes, Mataji.
Mataji, you're not in any buddy group. You are in Sadhu Sangha,
right?
No,
I'm not. I have not joined in any buddy group as yet, but I have been attending all your classes.
That is the reason for all those things, right?
Mataji, I would like to have the link or the way to get connected because I think I'm delayed, but I would like to.
You have to put it in the group and ask which buddy group is available.
Okay.
They grab you.
Okay, Mataji. Okay, Mataji. I'll do that. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Meenakshi, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Mataji.